Hi, I'm Ross, Hudson Mohawke, producer, DJ, composer. Today we're at my studio, The Health Farm in LA. Let's go and take a look. First and foremost, I think I'm a solo artist, DJ, producer. I still see that as sort of the core of what I do, even though I do production for other artists and other records. I've done a bunch of Kanye West stuff, Drake stuff, Pusha T, Chance the Rapper, Rick Ross, FK, Twigs, the Anoni record. So my Mellotron is on top of my sidecar here from output. I'm in the process of setting up. I've got my turntable on here. I needed a place to have a turntable that if I'm sampling, I don't have to get up and go to the other side of the room because I'm too lazy to do that. This is my Fat Bustard, which is a summing mixer. I have another interface here just in case there's something over here that needs an extra pair of inputs or something that don't stretch over to the main interfaces. Headphones, essentials, booby mug. Yeah, solid.
I've never really been one of these people who can work just from like a laptop or something like that. Like I really like having my own setup that I know where everything is. You know, I would work a lot on my own and sometimes to the point where I would be overcomplicating stuff for myself. And I feel like, you know, I'm quite into this approach that people have here of like, you know, someone texts you the day before and you're like, hey, you want to do something tomorrow? Make a bunch of music. I'm not meant to be like, you know, having a breakdown, trying to make a song or some shit like that. You know, it's meant to be a fun process.
Yeah, so this is a remix that I did towards the end of 2019, which is for this Glaswegian producer called Wooo. I actually used a bunch of the Portal plugin on this. The sort of idea I had for it was to do something that was gradually building all the way through because it's this repetitive arpeggio that kind of builds up and builds up and builds up. This is the one from the original track. And then I had replayed that on analog strings as well. It's a preset with a bunch of parameters changed in it, so it's kind of a little more messed up sounding. I have a couple of portals running as like sends throughout the course of it building up. There's progressively more and less being sent to each portal and it's sort of dropping in and out. So, I mean, dry is literally, it's literally just that loop running. Here's where all the sends are coming from to the different tracks, which all have instances of either portal or some other type of effect on them. And you see them. Progressively more chaotic, bringing in the different elements. But again, the core sound remains just the straight violin sound. The reason why I'm really into the output instruments and portal sounds terrible, but I don't want to spend fucking ages like learning the ins and outs of like, you know, some particular plugin. I really like things to be very hands-on and usable. He really struck a good balance there of interesting kind of sound design type ideas, but keeping it very user-friendly at the same time, which is really like a big thing for me. So I have a couple of collaborative projects. One is Tonight, which is me and Lunas, who's a Canadian producer. We just released another record just recently, and we're touring that over the next year or so. It's very kind of off the cuff And I think that comes across in the record as well. Like, it's left to be kind of slack and like flying by the seat of our pants doing it, you know what I mean? But it's still like bangs.
So this is the tonight track Dollaz, which is one of the tracks from the new record. And it's really just about like doing the most with the fewest elements and having the biggest sound from the fewest elements. The first element we added, I guess, after the vocals were chopped up, we added this little percussion loop, which is just like messing around with the Prophet 6 keyboard over here. It's never just like playing keys or something like that. It's very much like treating the piece of hardware as if the same way you would treat a sample from vinyl or from anywhere else. Linus had an acapella from someone which the phrase was not even, they just Dollaz, the phrase was something completely different. And he had chopped it up like that. So started off with a little vocal chop and the little
just Dollaz, they just Dollaz.
Added the exhale. With a lot of tonight stuff, I always look for these sounds that are kind of staccato sounds that are unfamiliar. I think I had favorited that particular exhale sound already from something, from skimming past it and doing something else for this particular track. Nothing could overpower the vocal element. Like, the vocal had to be the center of it. And so whatever melodic aspect you were going to add and whatever drums you're going to add have to complement that, but not overpower it, as it were. So that's this guy. It's called a Beholder. I actually don't even think I did anything. I think I've EQ'd it a little bit, and that's literally it. Yeah, so I have the Dave Smith Prophet here. I used to have the 12, and it was a little convoluted, a little kind of wasn't as immediately hands-on as this, and the 6 is really just like super instant. There's basically like, there's no menus in it or anything. It's just like a control for everything. Great sounds, super just like usable straight away. I've used it on tons of stuff. I used it on Dollaz, like I showed you earlier. I mean, I use it on almost everything. This is the M50, which is, I guess traditionally they'd be seen as kind of like cheesy, kind of like artificial emulations of real instruments, but in a kind of corny way. But that's what I kind of like about them. And I use that on a lot of my solo stuff. I really, really love this little, this is another guitar pedal, the Maris Hedra it's called. But it's basically like it's a delay, but also a pitch shifter that you can create these like really bizarre arpeggiated textures out of any source, really. Let me see where the kick came from. The kick came from a Waldorf keyboard, which it was used on the Runaway song, because it had like the live patches for like the Pusha T Kanye Runaway thing on it. But it had a couple of these other presets, and one of them was this kick. And I must have sampled it like a good few years ago and just always kept it. And I have the kick at all different pitches. Could shake the whole building here. It's as full as like an 808, but it's totally not an 808. It's a bit more industrial sounding, and a bit it has like just a sharper tone to it, where it really like hits you in the chest as well. I guess we got some like snares and percussion. Yeah, couple of snares layered up. Some kind of random sounds. A bunch of different like little effect things happen in the background.
The final thing is I have, you know, I like to use this little SSL fusion box, and I usually run most mixes through that just as the final stage.
For me, it is like all the power there is
it's all in the repetition, really. Like, it's all in how driving that thing is just like right into the center of your brain.
The day after he left, when we just finished it, I was out walking late at night and just had it in headphones, and I messaged him being like, fuck, I really, really fuck with this. Like, it's what you aim for with any project and you don't always get it, but like, I fuck with this. Anybody could say anything and I'm still gonna be like, this is fucking hard. I really am into this. You know, I felt like we did that.